With March now upon us and the NCAA gymnastics postseason on the horizon, four teams hold a massive opportunity tonight looking to improve their national qualifying score. Maryland welcomes in Central Michigan, George Washington, and the Tribe of William and Mary, and it's quad time in College Park, streaming live on Big Ten Plus. We welcome you into the Xfinity Center for the final time of the 2024 season. I'm Ryan Martin, joined alongside by Christina Chauvinet. And Christina, we'll touch on that national qualifying score first. A big opportunity in March here for all four of these teams entering postseason play soon.
March Madness is not just for basketball, it's for gymnastics too. And so really excited to see these teams. This is crunch time as it relates to college gymnastics. You're live with us here, College Gymnastics on BTN+. I'm really excited for this meet.
Yeah, really excited to see what we have here. Again, the four teams will introduce Central Michigan, George Washington, William and Mary, and Maryland here so far. A lot happening, and certainly some teams that maybe even have NCAA regionals hopefuls on the potential.
Yeah, this is a really exciting meet because we have three teams currently on the outside looking in for regionals. So you got Maryland. They are in that uncomfortable position right now, ranked 37th in the country. Mm-hmm. Top 36 make it to regionals. We've got 40th Central Michigan, GW's at 43. All of those teams could vie for a regional spot.
Yeah, we'll have to see what happens here. Again, a lot happening. The only lone quad meet of the season right now at Maryland. They're coming off a Big Five. We'll start with the Terps here. At Big Fives, Maryland not necessarily getting the first half. They wanted a really clean second half of the quad competition at Big Fives, but maybe that first half for Maryland really limited their potential in that meet with some of the top programs in the country.
Yeah, you know, Maryland has been really solid on vault and floor this season, but has not, you know, bars and beam are areas where they can be really strong, but they have had to count a fall here or there. So that's an area they're really trying to put together four complete rotations. If they do that, they're going to hit one. I believe they'll hit 186.
And we see now William and Mary, a local school, coming into this one. Christina, when we look around the gym right now and we see George Washington, Maryland, Central Michigan, it's not really William and Mary who's at that tier right now, but they certainly have very big expectations for themselves in the playoffs. And once that happens, we'll have to see if William and Mary can help their case out today by being here in College Park.
Absolutely. They are a team that tends to peak towards the latter half of the season. I commentated their conference championship last year. They had their season high there. They want to have a really strong performance there as well.
Yeah, another team here coming just from across the city in D.C. It's George Washington here for this one. They have a really nice routine, and they could make some serious noise in a really difficult group right now trying to qualify for regionals.
And bars is going to be, if that's where they're starting, that's a critical event for them because it has been their weakest event this season. So if they can put together five solid hits on bars, I think they're going to have a great meet.
Yeah, and we'll touch on the final team here. It is Central Michigan coming. The only team that's not coming from that D.C. region or obviously Maryland being here at home. But Central Michigan coming off two good meets where they hosted Kent State in their most recent one. A lot of good career highs there. And Central Michigan looking to add another performance and help out that national qualifying score and maybe drop one of those three road scores they have right now.
Absolutely. And we are going to bring you as much action as we can here, getting a look inside the Maryland huddle there for vault. Maryland will have that Olympic order as the home team. Remember, all teams rotate in that Olympic order, vault, bars, beam, and floor.
So Maryland against, we'll start on vault as we get ready for rotation number one. You mentioned Maryland will go Olympic order. They'll start on vault. George Washington will be your first one on bars. Central Michigan adds on beam, and William and Mary has a tough position of starting on floor first. A lot happening at once and ready to go for Maryland to start off our first vault of the day. How fitting, Christina. It's a senior here on senior night.
Yeah, and she's been so solid for them. A little bit of lineup shifts for them this season on vault, and she's coming into the leadoff spot. Same vaulters they've had, but in this leadoff spot this
Olivia Weir at leadoff for the first time this season.
Oh, and just opened up a little early, I think, was going a little too hard for that stick. Nice dynamics in the air, but had to take that hop forward, so that'll be a little deduction. Taking a look at the replay here. Yeah, and Central Michigan finishing up a nice beam routine there, Ashley Veglucci. Yeah.
to bars. Annalise Silverman getting it done there, starting it off for George Washington.
And Annalise Silverman, really key for them in that leadoff position, and does a nice job with that dismount.
Wrapping up our first leadoff spots there, you see Floor getting ready to go with Hannah Burke and William and Mary.
And William and Mary really has a nice diversity in their floor lineup in terms of the different styles. Each gymnast can choreograph their routine with their club coach at home, or some do their own choreography and are able to work on the music selection. So they're a fun team to watch on floor.
Around the gym, seconds in the lineup about to go. We got Central Michigan on beam, Karina Lankamer getting ready to go for vault. It'll be Maryland's Taylor Reck, the usual leadoff spot. Gonna try and follow up Olivia Weir's 9.775 there.
Wow, and drills that Yurchenko full. Really nice landing for her. She's really progressing nicely in terms of honing in that landing as we move towards postseason.
Sophomore has improved so much there. And onto floor, Hannah Burke once again on floor.
Just a little extra scoot there, but nice in the air on that double back. Good control in that leap to jump series.
Onto beam, Karina Lankamer following up Ashley Vigliucci's 9.725.
A nice switch split there on beam. Burke gearing up for her final tumbling pass. A nice dismount, that 1.5. That's going to be a common dismount we'll see this evening. And a nice open for William and Mary as well. Does that double back to open with lots of power.
See there the stick on bars. Delaney DeHaan, who followed up a 9.575 from Annalise Silverman at the one spot.
Yeah, and Delaney DeHaan really coming into her own in her first season. You can see her saying she was holding on to that stick. Got her career high last week, 9.85. So she's been really critical for this GW Bar squad.
To Central Michigan, back we go. It's Samantha Shannon, your leader in team average on beam so far this year. 9.775 she's averaging as we enter March. You can see her talking right there with head coach Christine McDonald, who said this is a beam event, Christina, that they're trying to find their confidence on. They have a lot of good depth on this event.
Absolutely, and I think one of the things that I was really impressed watching them is the lines that they show on beam. They have some really cool elements, including Shannon. She's going to do a side summing, which is one of my favorite skills to watch on this event.
One of two freshmen in this beam lineup for head coach Christine McDonald.
And I got to say, we're getting a look at the back of this Leo. I absolutely love Central Michigan's Leo. They are my Leo winner for the night.
A lot of good Leo options in the gym right now. We're talking about George Washington, maybe a bit of a brighter one with theirs, but the good colors and representing in the stands as well and on the gym.
As you mentioned, huge Central Michigan crowd here.
See on the screen there, Lankamer, 9.825 at the two spot before Shannon.
And I love that down on the beam work she does to open.
On the left side, it's Sophia Tyre following up a 9.75 from Delaney DeHaan. GW finding their footing back on bars on the left side of our screen after the 9.575 from Silverman.
And just powers through that half pirouette. Good fight there. Side summy on beam. That's that skill I was talking about. Handles it nicely. just the step forward on the dismount for Tyre, but another hit for GW.
GW finding their footing back right there as Shannon is able to get on beam.
Yeah, and I wonder if she was trying to connect that into the second, the split leap half, the split jump half, excuse me.
Second routine on floor, Melanie Faulkner following up a 9-7 from Hannah Burke.
And just a couple places, a couple hesitations there on beam for Shannon, but really cool work in there as well.
Right there is Faulkner on floor, Silberman with a 9.775 on vault. We do have a quad box option up on Big Ten Plus. A big shout out to our crew here working this event for getting that up on an alternate stream. We'll have some vault coverage coming up, but Maryland doing their thing so far on vault, which we'll see in a little bit on this main
feed. One and a half, front layout up. I thought she was going to be under-rotated there, but does a nice job of controlling that landing. Just a little stutter out of it. But another hit routine for William and Mary.
Back to the split we go, and we see George Washington once more. Rachel Katz after Tyre's most recent routine on bars still in evaluation.
Yeah, and Rachel Katz is really a very strong contributor for GW here. So, you know, I think they're off to a really solid start so far. Once they get through bars, the next three events for them are super high-scoring potential. So when I had a chance to talk to the coaching staff beforehand, they said bars had been going really well in practice this week. And so really nice to see them, you know, hit the routines so far.
It's interesting you mentioned how important bars is for George Washington. It's going to be a really important event and a telling event for all four of the teams in the gym today after they struggled on bars in their most recent outing, all of them, really.
Absolutely. That is going to be a critical event for all teams. And, you know, some teams will prefer to start on a certain event, and other teams might prefer to get that their challenging event out of the way. And so, you know, I think that, but for all these teams, they're going to be moving into postseason where they might have to start on different events than they're used to. Quads are really important. We heard that from the coaches we talked to. They're really important at this time of season to get these athletes used to starting anywhere.
And this is a team that knows that maybe truer than anyone here. We see right there Quinn Skrupa, and we talked to head coach Christine McDonald. This will be their order starting on beam for the MAC competition. We know how important those conference championships are to NCAA regional seeding.
Absolutely.
Skrupa, one of the two all-arounds for Central Michigan, as we see GW getting ready to go on bars as well. Skrupa, one of two all-arounders for Central Michigan, and both all-arounders are coming from an international influence. Skrupa coming from Manitoba, Canada.
And, oh, nice job there to keep that on the beam. Pretty big, was pretty far off on that back handspring layout step out. And nice bail handstand. Good work so far for GW on bars. Good connection in that aerial split leap. And big full twisting double back. Just that hop on bars. But again, she gets mobbed by her teammates. Good job for Katz. And just the scoop back on that one and a half, but another solid routine for Central Michigan. Just the and break in the hips and that back handspring layout step out, of course, that will be a deduction as well.
Madeline Frazier, we're now seeing on floor.
Nice 1.5 to front layout. And, you know, I think one of the things that William and Mary has really been working on is that endurance for that last tumbling pass, and that showed there.
From floor to beam, Skrupa still on evaluation, but it's Adriana Bustello for Central Michigan now on beam, the senior for Mason, Ohio. We get a look as well for bars. It's a fantastic gymnast. It's Kendall Whitman.
Yeah, and this is a new event for her this year, really known for the power events, vault and floor, but has added bars this year. Some leg separation in that ginger to bail to handstand. Goes after that last handstand, and this is a highlight for me. Such a cool dismount. Nice job. Just a couple leg separation places that will be a deduction.
We'll see Whitman in a couple other events later today, including a very special vault routine that we'll have to keep an eye on, especially later in the rotation.
So again, dynamic.
Bustello on beam.
Oh, tough break there. She was off in that back handspring, and once you're off in that initial, the first element of the series, difficult to get back on track. They do have a couple of 9.65s in front, so those are gonna be scores they need to count.
We talked to head coach Christine McDonald, knowing the importance of this opportunity in terms of substituting out one of your road NQS scores. It's gonna be Central Michigan competing from behind a little bit after a beam event that they'd like to have back.
And I love that combination, though, the kick out, the B jump kick out into that aerial.
Floor on the right side of your screen, it's Michelle No.
And she's such a beautiful athlete to watch on this event. Really powerful tumbling and dynamic performance. One and a half front layout. It's a little big lunge out of there, but nice dynamics in that twist. Really pretty work.
On to bars. The finale for George Washington, Maya Peters, comes at 6.
And Maya Peters handles that pack salto. Thought she caught it a little bit close. And just shy on that final handstand as well. Oh, gosh. You know, she was shy on that handstand, and I don't think she had the tap that she needed. And by that, I mean didn't get the power through that swing down to get that full pirouette all the way around.
Yeah, through the first five gymnasts on bars, 3.9575s are lower for George Washington.
Yeah, and again, this is not their strongest event, and so I think that they really are, you know, those scores are now going to have to count, the 9.5s and the 9.525s. But too bad, this is an athlete that really, Peters, that shows a lot of promise, just not her day. Just not her day. We're going to see her on beam. She's lovely there as well.
To beam we go now, and it's one of the most interesting gymnasts we have in the gym today, a 2020 Olympian from Costa Rica, Lucy Alvarado Reed, the sophomore.
And I just absolutely love her work. The extension, it's gorgeous.
Alvarado Reed, the second all-arounder for Central Michigan.
And Grace Costello getting started for William and Mary on floor. Oh, and looks like there was just a music error there. Don't know if they weren't playing her correct music, but just on pause. Nice leap series for Alvarado Reed in the interim. Yeah, I just love her posture her, the way that she works on releve, it really is exquisite. And they needed that one. Really big performance. That's the performance of an Olympian.
The sophomore comes through in a big way from the anchor spot at six. Alvarado Reed, which could easily have been Central Michigan's best routine on beam in our first rotation.
And this is a fun routine. Nice double pike. Oh, just couldn't keep that in bounds. Fought for it, though. You know, had that extra power, went out of bounds on that middle pass, but I really liked that double pike at the beginning. That was a highlight of the routine for me.
On exhibition, Central Michigan, Amber Mueller, our first exhibitionist of the day for Central Michigan.
And goes for that difficult switch split, switch half combination. Was a little shy on that second split.
Mueller here on exhibition, following up a new season high for Lucy Alvarado Reed.
And sinks into that dismount. Nice option for them, particularly as they had some struggles earlier in the rotation. But yeah, I mean, Alvarado Reed, she's so pretty to watch. Just absolute dynamite, so consistent for them, coming through right when they needed her.
So Mueller, you saw the exhibition. So we do have the first rotation scores, which are posted. You can see right there for Maryland, Central Michigan, and George Washington. Just waiting on Sophie Chandler. You can see her right there speaking with William and Mary. They're ready to go here, and we'll see if Sophie Chandler can bring them up here at the sink spot.
And there you go, seeing the updated score there for William and Mary. If you like to follow the stats, if you want to know what the scoring splits are, you can head on over to Verdius. You can check out start values, all that fun stuff.
Sophie Chandler, lone gymnast in the final rotation yet to go, and she'll be looking to score 9.6 or higher to up William and Mary's score at the moment.
And she's another gymnast I just love to watch on this event. A little shy on rotation in that front double full, but difficult E-rated pass. Good control out of that punch front. does that round off layout step out to fulfill the back tumbling requirement. William and the WM choreographed into all their routines. Little couple of imprecisions here and there in the tumbling, but just has really nice presence on floor, and I enjoy that she's going for that difficulty, going for that front double full.
Similar to what we just saw with Central Michigan, Alvarado Reed at that anchor spot gives an anchor type score. Could have seen that there with Chandler. Now we'll take a look at Maryland, who puts up a 4.895 on vault. Some really solid routines here. It starts with Weir and then goes with Reck.
Yeah, again, a little bit of changes in the vaulting lineup, but Taylor Reck nailing that landing there. Emma Silberman returning to the vault lineup with her full-on pike off, 9.85 there. And Alexa Rothenbusher here with that 10-0 vault, that souk full. Natalie Martin, this huge 1.5, just shorter than I'm used to seeing from her on that. And then another nice Yurchenko full to round out that rotation.
Good first rotation from Maryland. We'll see what rotation number 2 brings for all 4 of our teams. Central Michigan, George Washington, William Mary, and the Terps are coming up next on Big Ten Plus. We're back here on Big Ten Plus. 1 rotation through, 3 to go here between Maryland, George Washington, Central Michigan, and William and Mary. And we'll start here on beam.
And I mean, Lucy Alvarado Reed, just absolutely stunning lines. We're going to see more of the same for her as she moves through all around.
To floor we go, where the Tribe put up some good numbers, a 48.4 for William and Mary.
Yeah, you know, I thought they did a really nice job. This was an event they struggled on a little bit last week and saw some really nice tumbling, that double back, really nice height there.
On bars, it was George Washington with some routines they'd like back.
Yeah, you know, this isn't their best event. Getting a look at Delaney DeHaan there, who had a great routine for them.
And again, vault, Emma Silberman on senior night. Silberman back in the vault lineup.
Yeah, and she did a great job with that vault, legs together in the air. Solid job.
You see what Maryland did there, a 48.95, let all 4 teams in the first event, and highlighted there by Joe Kogler, a 9.85.
Yeah, really solid rotation for them. Now they are moving to bars where they had to count a fault last week.
On Central Michigan, it was the beam lineup, again, highlighted by the anchor, Lucy Alvarado Reed, a 9.875. And they got a couple other good contributors with Lankheimer in there, too.
Yeah, you know, they did have to count a couple of minor mistakes, and they're moving to a really strong event for them on floor. Can't wait to see it.
On floor, it was William and Mary. Their biggest contribution came from Michelle Noe, a 9.75. And they'll look to keep going up from the 48.4.
Yeah, and vault is an exciting event for them because it's an area where they made a lot of upgrades during the offseason, twisting all of their vaults that we're going to see in lineup tonight. And they looked great on vault last week.
And at the rear, as we mentioned, it was George Washington, a 48.075. On bars, going to try and improve after already having their worst event out of the way.
Yeah, you know, they didn't have to count a fall, but they did have to count some, you know, mistakes, some leg separations, things like that. They're moving to beam, which is a really strong event for them.
And from Olympic order, we'll go down for rotation number 2. On vault, William and Mary. We'll get it started with Grace Costello. And the expectations for the Tribe on vault, Christina.
Yeah, you know, like I said, they upgraded a lot of their vaults in the off season. Last year, they were competing some vaults in the lineup that were Yurchenko layouts, only a 9.75 start for those Yurchenko layouts. So they're all of their start values are 9.9 plus now. That is a big area, particularly for the GEC, to have all of those vaults be twisting and be competitive. I'm looking forward to it.
We'll have to watch the Tribe on vault. The Terps go to bars, an event they extremely had a lot of struggles with at Big Five up in State College, looking to do better back on their home court.
And you know, last time they were here, we saw them knock it absolutely out of the park on bars. They've changed around their lineup a little bit, starting with Victoria Gatzendorfer, who's been really consistent for them this season.
So Gatzendorfer can do a fixture on bars, and to beam, George Washington goes, where they'll start with Annalise Silverman. She'll look to bounce back after a bar routine that wasn't something that she was looking for.
Yeah, and they have some strong freshman competitors here. Brooke Izzo's coming off a career-high 9-9 last week. Maya Peters got a 9-9-2-5 earlier in the season. And so, you know, she's got a really challenging acro series. They've got some unique combinations in this rotation, so they have an opportunity to set this meet back on the right foot.
And on floor, Central Michigan looking to start it off with Ken Skrupa, again at 48-7-2-5 in their most recent event on beam. They'll be on floor, our Central Michigan.
And Skruba's got some lovely tumbling here and really pretty lines on her dance. Nice control out of that 1.5 to front layout. Annalise Silverman getting started here for GW on beam. Little hesitation into that aerial, but keeps the connection to the backhand springs. And just a little shy of that double back on floor, but finesses the landing. Clean through that aerial. And she's such a solid lead off for Central Michigan, really doing her job in the all around.
That's an event where they really had great success in last time out, as we see Maryland get started on bars. For Central Michigan, a 49.475 last time, their highest event of all season, there's Getzendorfer on bars.
Yeah, you know, not the way that she wanted to get that routine, the rotation off, but she did recover on that dismount. And Silverman just really, she's in that lineup position on multiple events for a reason, just a really solid competitor for GW. And one of the things I like about GW, as we get a look here, you can see some of the live action happening here side by side. They have unique combinations, not just on beam, we're gonna see that on floor and on vault. It just makes it really fun to watch.
Saying, you got this right there, it's Sarah Cooper. Check that instead, it'll be Sarah Zoys. Wrong Sarah.
Lots of gymnastics going on here at the Xfinity Center. And so now the pressure's back on Maryland, right? Yeah. They have to, remember, in college gymnastics, 6-5 count. So they can drop that score. You're getting a look at Tasha Brzozowski here, who has been very consistent for Maryland this season.
Now Brzozowski again feeling the lineup change right here. So she'll be in the two spot. Get going with head coach Brett Nelligan in his 15th year. There's a look, really the quarterback of what Maryland's able to do on bars. Central Michigan onto floor. The second routine comes from Elizabeth Buttle. And Buttle, the senior from Shaftesbury, Vermont. Not a lot of gymnasts you'll see at this level from Vermont, but it's going to be Buttle here.
And Brzozowski, this double layout, did exactly what she needed to do there. Big routine for Maryland. And Sarah Zoys underway for GW here. She's one of the athletes doing this triple series. And finesses that landing because she was a little off in the air on that layout step out. Hangs on to that double back on her toes. Nice job on those jumps, getting them all the way around.
Battle coming off two straight 9-9s, and certainly could have another one here at 2 for Central Michigan.
And Zoice, I just love to watch her on beam. Just such pretty extension through her leaps. One of the only gymnasts doing that difficult double twist hangs on to it there.
The talk right now between Nelligan and Sierra Kondo. It's been a fixture again at this bar, in this bar lineup for Maryland. A really solid contributor all season long.
Yeah, and she is, you know, again, they, you know, they all know they are in a must-hit situation at the moment, but she's such a capable bar worker, really pretty Jaeger that she showcases off the top here as well.
Brzezowski's score comes in. It's a 9-7-7-5 after Gatzendorfer's 9-2-5.
And Annalise Silverman got GW started with a 9-8-5, still waiting on Zoice's score. Big, pretty Jaeger there, clean into that overshoot. Nice double layout.
Split box again. It's Elizabeth Ciceroni, the senior, in the three spot for Central Michigan. Competing in three events, and she will be on exhibition for vault later.
Front full front layout. Nice and confident in that landing. Brooke Izzo getting started for GW here. Some solid routines to start for GW.
And the bounce back they needed with Silverman's 9-8-5, Zoice's 9-7-5. Now Izzo going lot.
Oh, wow, she really fought for that back heel off the beam there. What a champ.
Every muscle in that left foot was able to keep her on the beam.
And another fight on floor because she was a little under-rotated on that double back, but these athletes, they know what time of season it is, and they're fighting for every 10th, and I absolutely love to see it.
You mentioned at the top, March is not just for the brackets of basketball, but the most important times for the national qualifying score in NCAA gymnastics. We talked about it a little bit earlier, but this is a year in which you look back at 2023 and the scores that are needed to get to a regional, certainly higher than they were just a year ago.
Absolutely, and all, you know, the three teams that we discussed that are in this hunt, GW, Central Michigan, and Maryland, they're in the unfortunate position of currently in the season being on the outside looking in. Now, there's a million different mathematical permutations of how this could go, and if you're a stats nerd like myself, you love to think about all the different ways this could play out. But what these teams know is that they got to start, they need to put 196s on the board if they want to be competitive, because as you mentioned, the scores are trending higher than they did last year.
You get a look at Emma Silberman, again, one of four seniors being honored tonight for Maryland. As part of senior night, you can see the deep breath comes from Silberman, her first time in the bars lineup since January 27th at Minnesota.
And is through her Ginger there, her major release. A little shy on that handstand, but nice handstand on the low bar. Silberman, you know, just has contributed so much to this Maryland program. Graduate student getting her master's in special education. Big floaty double layout, good for her.
Lucy Alvarado-Reed, a floor routine you're going to want to see from the Costa Rican here. To go with Silverman, you mentioned a second team All Big Ten selection a year ago.
Oh, gosh, and just was going to highlight that memel turn and just struggled with it. So difficult, that double turn with the leg pulled up. One and a half front layout, clean there. Her sister does her choreography, so family affair here. Mm-hmm. A end up Kendall Whitman getting started on beam. And this is where she really starts to showcase the unique skill sets that she does.
How about a heavyweight split box right here between Alvarado Reed and Whitman on
absolutely.
The left side?
This is what's fun about quads. So much great gymnastics going on side by side.
Thank you for tuning into either our main feed here with our split box, or if you want all four, we have the quad option available on Big Ten Plus to go check out.
Front aerial to round off. Don't see that very often in NCAA. And does this switch split jump so difficult? She's just, all of the skills that she does, she's really quick with everything that she does, and she shows that on beam as well as on the event she's best known for, which is floor and vault.
So the score comes in as well. Silverman, a 9.85 on bars. It's her season high between five meets that she's been on the bar lineup this season.
And check out this dismount front full. Reese McClure, Maryland alum, competed that last year, and just really fun. I just love her gymnastics.
Back to bars we go. Someone new to the lineup this year, another senior though, who's contributed whenever needed. Alexa Rothenbucher has been solid at this five spot.
Yeah, and you know, she has been training bars, said, you know, she was candid, didn't know if she was gonna make it into the lineup, but just kind of kept chipping away at it, and here she is. Shows off her power in this big, full twisting, double back. Wow, that's the best I've seen her do it. I love the way Maryland's rallied in this rotation.
Yeah, we were mentioning during the rotation break, Christina, but Maryland's still looking to drop a 1.958 that they have at home for that NQS score. And this is the final opportunity they have. It's all road from here on out. And so Rothenbucher doing her part on bars and looking to help out the Central Michigan away NQS here on floor. It's Haley Hornbaker.
Yeah, and you know, unusual for Alvarado Reed to have that fall. As I mentioned, that turn that she goes for is so difficult. Hornbacher is very, very capable on this event as well. Front layout to Rudy. Good control out of that lunge. Maya Peters for GW on beam. Drills that double back. Are you kidding me? And Hornbacher doing exactly what she needed to do there.
Yeah, the senior came into this meet leading the team with a 9.878 average on floor for a reason. Another performance there. On two bars on the right side of our split box, Rhea LeBlanc.
And Maya Peters doing that gorgeous aerial to layout step out. Again, rare in NCAA gymnastics. One of the things that makes GW stand out for me is LeBlanc gets ready for a dismount. Nice floaty double layout. Just that little step to correct, but the back of that lineup did their jobs.
9.775 comes in for Rothenbucher, which follows up the 9.85 from Silberman. Maryland bounces back there.
And such a cool combo here. Switch split into the gainer pike. You know, she did have that fall on bars, and so really nice to see her rebound. I absolutely love her lines. This is an athlete I'm watching. I think she's got a bright future in NCAA.
Right down the road, too, at George Washington, it's Maya Peters. Out of floor, not necessarily down the road at Central Michigan. Ashley Viglucci, and she comes up after Hornbacher's 9.9.
And what stood out to me about Hornbacher compared to the other routines we've seen, not just earlier in the lineup, but in the previous rotation, is the control that she had out of every single one of those tumbling passes. Remember, on floor, you're allowed to take a controlled step back. And I have to say, as an analyst, people ask me what that means a lot. And the easiest way to say it is, you know it when you see it. It should look like the athlete is taking this step because they want to, not because they have to. And she really exhibited that, was well rewarded.
9-8 comes for Rhea LeBlanc. Here's again Viglucci. Hornbacher following up Alvarado Reed, a 9-1-7-5. Hornbacher comes back with a 9-9, too.
Clean double full there to open. And really nice control out of that second tumbling pass as well. Nancy Kiner getting started here for GW, last competitor. Great routine to end them off there for Viglucci. Maya Peters, 9-9-2-5.
Yep.
Tying her season and as a freshman career high. Coincidentally, I've commentated both of those routines, so maybe I'm a good luck charm.
Good luck charm. Maybe they should take you over to their conference championships.
Yeah, exactly. Well, I'm coincidentally commentating their conference championship, so there you go. Aerial backhand spring clean there. Oh, and just a little misstep on that choreography there. Keeps that connection. You can see her giving herself a couple of verbal cues. Pretty common for athletes to talk to themselves during routines. Doing that gainer pike. You know, just had that kind of awkward bobble on her choreography, but I really like her lines on beam and had some really pretty moments in that routine.
Kiner finishes up beam for George Washington, and we'll take a look at the vault. The Tribe get it done with a 48-3-2-5.
Yeah, and this getting a look at Grace Costello here with this tucked full. That's out of a 9-9. Gets good height on that. Sarah Cooper here doing this Yurchenko half. She's really honed in that landing. Sophia Huang doing that full twisting Yurchenko. Some pike in the hips. You see she has to take that hop forward. 9-6-7-5 for her. Caroline Blanchford, they're all around her this evening, doing that tucked full. Was just a little crunched on the table, but she got the twist around really quickly. Impressed with her air awareness there. Hannah Burke, again, another one that was just a little crunched on the table, but got that Yurchenko half around, also a 9-9-5 start. And Michelle No doing the layout, that's out of a 9-7, went 9-5 there.
And watching Noah to see what she's able to do for the Tribe. We're halfway through here in College Park, but you won't want to miss an exciting third rotation. That's all coming up next on Big Ten Plus. And we're back on Big Ten Plus, getting ready for rotation number 3 in Maryland's lone home quad meet. Ryan Martin alongside Christina Chauvernay. Christina, let's pull up the highlights from rotation 2. It starts with Emma Silverman killing her first bar routine in over a month.
Yeah, really nice on this double layout here. Handled this beautifully. Again, she's contributed so much to this team. Maya Peters on beam. One of my favorite beam workers. Switch split to gainer pike. So pretty. Rewarded with that 9-9-2-5. Well deserved.
On floor, the Central Michigan. Yep.
Haley Hornbacher just demonstrating great control here in her tumbling. Dynamic performance, 9-9.
So rotation 3, as we just kind of saw, It'll be Central Michigan going to coming out of floor where they had, again, a really nice performance from Hornbacher, who feels like a 9-9 machine here for Central Michigan.
Yeah, they really recovered nicely after that fall. We're seeing that a lot this meet. I'm loving the way that these athletes have their teammates' backs, picking it up after they've had a fall in the rotation.
William and Mary, we didn't see them on vault. We saw it in the package after, but a 48-3-2-5.
Yeah, and you know, I think that I've seen them a little cleaner on some of those landings, but really important for them to build that difficulty as they're moving towards postseason. Sarah Cooper, a highlight for me there, really nailing that landing on her vault.
In Maryland, we mentioned what Emma Silverman did with a 9.85, a really nice bounce back for the senior on senior night. Another really good score as well from Maria LeBlanc.
Yeah, you know, they were, again, had some, same with Central Michigan, had some adversity in that lineup. The rest of the athletes in there did their jobs. Little leg separation, short handstand here or there, but they're going to be happy walking away with the 49, just shy of that 196 pace.
And the best team in rotation number two, a 49.175 from George Washington, and it's highlighted by, as you mentioned, Maya Peters.
Yeah, love her work, and really across this lineup, they really did their jobs, and they're moving into two events that are absolutely powerhouses for them.
So let's take a look at our quad box right now on Big Ten Plus. You can see all four teams getting ready to go in their respective event for rotation three. Maryland on beam, George Washington on floor in the bottom left. We get a look, and we'll see more later about Central Michigan on vault and the high rise from the bird's eye view angle of the William and Mary on bars.
Yeah, and getting a look at GW warming up here, and they have a lot of difficulty. Really exciting and fun team. All these teams are fantastic to watch on floor, but they have some really difficult tumbling in here.
So to start, we'll take a look at Central Michigan for vault. And they'll start off with Jenna Germond, a freshman who starts off a big spot at vault.
Yeah, and they have all 9.95 starts doing those Yurchenko fulls. Really nice dynamics in their vaults. This is their highest rated event. And, you know, Gurman getting them off to has been really solid for them in that lead up position this season.
On bars, William and Mary will start off with Sarah Cooper. Just saw her have a really good spot on vault, and she'll try to start things off for the tribe on bars.
And, you know, William and Mary, this event has been up and down for them this season. Aisha Laird and Catherine Baer are some of their top contributors. They have some really big Tkachevs to highlight this rotation.
On beam, it's Maryland. They'll start off with the graduate, Emma Silberman.
Yeah, Emma Silberman, again, continuing her senior night. Komorowski and Kogler, such a 1-2 punch there, or 5-6 punch, I should say, closing it out.
Finish off our rotation three, George Washington. They start with Peyton Lynch, her first appearance so far tonight.
Yeah, she's a floor specialist, and boy, is she special, because she really has lovely form on this event.
That's an exciting one. We'll have to see in our split box how George Washington can do on floors. Rotation three just about to get set underway. We see Maryland again. She's got a couple freshmen here. It's interesting that they'll go with Silberman, the graduate, Layla Hammer, who's really coming to her own on this beam lineup, and then Natalie Martin will try and keep the momentum going at three.
Yeah, and I think that they're going to be feeling really good coming off of bars and recovering the way they did. They've got some good momentum. And Sarah Cooper getting started for William and Mary here. And didn't quite see the finish of that double layout on camera, but really nice landing for her. Good start for them. And just seeing the end of Peyton Lynch's first pass there. She's such a fun performer.
As you see for beam, again, getting going, is Silberman for the dismount.
And Liz just nails that double back. And the series there for Silverman, that triple series confidence, just some, a little bit of knee bend in that layout step out. And a couple of nice leap series there, side by side here in this box. Great start for GW on floor. Just the hop on beam for Silverman, but a solid start for them as well.
So we see the first of GW on floor. We'll go back to William and Mary now, Asha Laird.
And she has this big Tkachev there. Oh, and I thought that she was a little bit off on that release to low bar, but handles it nicely. Full turn into that double back. Really nicely done there.
The quiet floor right now. We'll take a quick look at vault with Ken Skrupa. Again, someone who's been so important for Christina McDonald and the Central Michigan team this year. She'll follow up Jenna Germond's 9.75 to start off the vault lineup for Central Michigan.
Yeah, and an athlete that's come into competing the all-around this season and really has good form, clean technique in all of her skills, including this full twisting Yurchenko.
So Skrupa, who we just mentioned, we'll correct that. Apologies for that. Skrupa put up a 9.65 before that. So Shannon Smith, Samantha Shannon on the screen now, but Skrupa still a fantastic athlete.
And hangs on to that full twisting. I thought she might stick that full twisting Yurchenko, but nice job with the landing there.
A 9.85 to start the beam lineup for Maryland with Silverman. We go from graduate to freshman. It's Layla Hammer.
And Marley York here for GW on floor. Good control out of 1.5 to front full, difficult. Oh, and Hammer, tough break there on beam. Nice double back to finish for York. She's such a quick twister. Hammer hangs on to that dismount. You know, tough break, as you said. She has worked her way into the lineup this season and has some really nice qualities on beam. And Tori Sipes getting set here on bars for William and Mary. Oh, excuse me, Catherine Bear. And some solid scores coming in here for William and Mary. 9.65, 9.525 so far.
And the importance of adding up those scores now, again, as we mentioned, we'll be looking to make the conference championships evening sessions, and those ones, if they keep adding them up, to put them in a prime position in the DC area.
And Tori Sipes score now in 9.675. And getting set for Catherine Bear here, who is one of their top contributors on bars. And here's that Tkachev. Nice job there. Same composition we saw from Laird earlier. Just a little shy on that handstand. Full turn into the double back. That step back, but pretty in the air. Casey Burke getting started. First of two Brittany routines we'll see tonight. And this is a huge first pass. Double front. It was a little short, but she's so strong. Just manages to use her leg strength to keep that in control.
On to beam. It's Natalie Martin, the freshman, in a similar spot we saw her to when Ohio State came to College Park. The freshman trying to follow up a fall, and she's had experience, almost a veteran mindset Martin has on beam.
Yeah, she's really been solid for Maryland, clean through that back handspring layout step out where she did have a mistake last week. Just a little shy on split in that switch-split combination, clean in that final pass for Burke. Burke, a sophomore, but really did not compete last season, really put in a lot of work in the offseason, and she's so powerful. 1.5 was just shy on that, has to have that scoot back, but that was a critical routine for Maryland. And Caroline Blanchford getting started here on bars for William and Mary. Clean in that full turn. Oh, she just needed to sink her heels in a little bit, would have had that stick, takes that small hop back, but she has such lovely lines. I really like to watch her on bars.
Blatchford follows up again, a solid William and Mary lineup on bars so far. Catherine Baird, the most recent Tribe member, to put up a 9-7 before, as we see Victoria Gatzendorfer with a huge resource for Maryland. It's assistant coach Aaron Dooley, who's meant so much on beam for this Terps program.
Well, and Ryan, you know, I was a fan of Aaron back when I was a club gymnast, fantastic gymnast in her own right, national team member, and getting a look at Annalise Silverman in the double box here for GW on floor.
Victoria Gatzendorfer, the transfer from Missouri. Junior going to try and follow up a 9.825 from Natalie Martin. Again, a solid return from Martin after a routine in front of her that the gymnast would like back.
Yeah, really clutch performance there from Martin. Oh, and was a little off in that 1.5, but handles it into the front layout for Silverman. Gatzendorfer, great job on that triple series. In that switch split to split jump for Gatzendorfer. And Silverman, really nice tumbling form there. Great performance quality. And just the dismount for Gatzendorfer. That little baby hop there, but I just love her toe point on beam. Really exquisite. And good to see her come back from that adversity on bars.
Awaiting the score for Gatzendorfer there. Maddie Komorowski will be up next for Maryland at 5. But back to bars we go. Sarah Wozniak at the anchor for the Tribe. So as we await Wozniak, her routine on bars, a look here, Christina, at one of the most interesting trophies maybe in NCAA gymnastics. It is this fork-spoon combination for Central Michigan. We asked head coach Christina McDonald. She's not letting the secret out as to what it is.
Absolutely, yeah. It's up to you to decide. And Deanna Sharametta getting started for GW on floor. Nice control out of that one and a half to front layout. And she's so pretty to watch on floor. Look at the toe point throughout this choreography.
Back to Maryland, we mentioned the sophomore Maddie Komorowski starting this routine she's become so well known for in College Park.
And this is beautiful gymnastics side by side. Look at this switch ring. Beautiful split positions. Maddie Komorowski shows that same toe point. Gosh, I am just loving seeing these two side by side. Meant to be. Ugh, just gorgeous finish position. And for hardcore NCAA gymnastics fans, if you're wondering, is she of any relation to Alisa Sharametta from former Mizzou All-American? Yes, she is. That's her sister. Same great style for those two athletes. And Maddie Komorowski, a joy to watch here. Look at the splits. Switch split to split jump. Stunning. Clean through that full turn. Just her dismount. We'll see if she can get the stick on this one and a half. Hangs on to it. They might take a half a tenth for that arm circle, but she is stunning on beam, and I think that's the best I've seen her this season.
And when we talk about the Olympic order, too, going from beam to floor, Komorowski, the sophomore, been such a versatile presence, able to we've seen what she can do on floor, having a tremendous floor routine against at Big Tens, but now adding the beam, Komorowski really coming into her own.
Absolutely. She's so pretty to watch and just really exemplary technique. And you're getting a look at one of the fiercest floor competitors, not in this competition, in the country. The only athlete in the country doing 3E passes. She's the moment. She's Kendall Whitman.
Kendall Whitman, everybody.
Only athlete doing 3E passes, those most difficult rated. Here's her first one. Double front. Bam. Unreal. Getting ready for her second E-pass here. Front double full, front layout. Ridiculous control.
With a split box here, Joe Kogler able to step up on beam at the sixth spot for Maryland after Christina, a 9.925 for Komorowski.
Yeah, I mean, as I said, I think that's the best I've ever seen her do. And she's just really has, I think they probably just took a little on that arm, on the arm wave in that lat on her dismount. But Kendall Whitman, speaking of putting scores into the 9.9s, just one last E-pass here. Front double full. Great control out of that as well. I certainly expect to see that in the 9.9s.
Yeah, we'll have to see what Whitman gets scored for. Again, Komorowski did have a 9.9, a 9.925, a new career high for the sophomore.
Yeah, it's just, again, absolutely stunning work. And I love, as I mentioned, having her and Josephine Kogler back-to-back, they really show this exceptional quality, not just hitting their skills, but look at the toe point in the air in these skills, just those minor details that set them apart. Nice stretch through that switch split, split jump combination. She's such a calm and composed beam worker, really takes her time through all of those elements. Chest up on that landing. Again, that's really gonna be in the running for her career high as well.
Back to back 1-2 punch again between Komorowski and Kogler. Right before Maryland's best event, which is floor coming up next in our fourth rotation.
Yeah.
Before that, let's take a look at the vault. Central Michigan getting it done, and it comes, the best one being Elizabeth Cicerone.
And I think this is Jenna Gurman that we're seeing here, that full twist. So we're going to see all of the athletes here. Quinn Skrupa in this, doing the full twist. And Yurchenko just a little short on that, has that step forward. Samantha Shannon here. Nice dynamics. Just couldn't quite control that landing. And Zoe Pelfrey here. The little step back. Good chest position on landing. And Lucy Alvarado-Reed. Nice body position in the air. Just that hop back. I love the way she keeps her legs together throughout that vault. Elizabeth Cicerone here, their high score. Nice, she flares it out at the end there. That really is exceptional work.
You can see the team, what it meant for Cicerone right there. And we'll have our fourth rotation coming up. We'll see that Central Michigan team coming up on bars and what everyone else giving one more rotation through. The final rotation coming up on Big Ten Plus. And we're back for the final rotation on Big Ten Plus. Ryan Martin alongside Christina Chauvenet. Let's take a look at the rotation three highlights. It starts on a new season high for the William and Mary Tribe.
Yeah, and getting a look at Caroline Blanchford here. And this was they had a season high here, 48.475, full turn into double back. And Maddie Komorowski there, yeah, season high, excuse me. And Maddie Komorowski here, so pretty in this, in the fifth position here for Maryland. Does this 1.5 dismount, really great form throughout, just was a little forward on that dismount, and I think that's where they docked 9.925 though, great. Kendall Whitman does what Kendall Whitman does, absolutely phenomenal on this event. Big double front there. Somebody's got to give this woman a 10. 9.925. I'm with the 9.95 judge there.
Let's look at the George Washington scores on floor. Again, you mentioned 9.925. Whitman's so close right there, but just not there yet for the senior.
Yeah, and as I said, I think a 10 isn't coming for her on floor. So dynamic. And really the GW lineup across the board, lots of difficulty, lots of great control, and they're moving to their best event on vault.
We look now at vault that Central Michigan had. Again, we mentioned Lucy Alvarado-Reed, a 9.8. Elizabeth Cicerone, 9.85, a good 5.6 right there for the Chippewas.
Yeah, you know, they've been a little cleaner on vault throughout this season, but still a solid rotation for them. And really, and now they have the opportunity to finish this meet on a really high note on bars.
And the Tribe aren't able to get a new season high on bars if not for the 9.8 from Caroline Blanchford.
And yes, and my apologies, I believe that was Wozniak that we saw in those highlights, but Caroline Blanchford, career high for her, 9.8 there, and season high for the Tribe, 48.475.
From one season high to another season high, it was Maryland on beam. And again, Komorowski, 9.925, Kogler, a 9.9. That's how you get it done there for 5.6 in the Terps.
Yeah, you know, they, as I mentioned at the top, those, the back end of those, that 1-2 punch with Komorowski and Kogler, really just beautiful toe point, excellent execution, and they were rewarded as they should be.
So we won't see it in live time, but with George Washington on vault, a big one to watch. It's at number three, Kendall Whitman doing the Whitman.
Yeah, and I mean, she's got a vault named after her. What can you say? And I really love the ingenuity that she has, that she really leaned into what she liked to do, didn't like to back tumble, and so she does all front tumbling skills, including on vault. And they've got some other big vaults in there, including Casey Burke's Sukful.
Take a look at the replay of that vault. When it comes for Central Michigan, they'll be on bars, and they'll start again with Ashley Vaglucci.
Yeah, and you know, this was a place where they struggled last week, so an opportunity for them to end this meet on a high note. And even though they struggled last meet, Alvarado Reed, 9.95, just absolutely stunning lines on bars.
Yeah, career high Alvarado Reed is coming off of. To the Tribe we go on beam. They'll start with Sarah Cooper. She had the leadoff spot for a couple of rotations so far today.
Yeah, and that is one of the things when I talked to Coach Kelsey Hinton. She said that Sarah is a really calm competitor, really somebody that she relies on in that leadoff spot. Caroline Blatchford back on this event with her triple series. And freshman Melanie Faulkner shows off great lines on this
event.
And
for the final time at home in front of the faithful in 2024, it's Maryland's floor lineup with a lot of pizzazz. You got Taylor Rex started with the RuPaul-themed routine. And then we'll see a little bit later Alexa Rothenbucher again with the Brittany lineup.
Yeah, and it's always fun to see the senior night, and it's going to be a great time.
To bars we start. It's Ashley Vaglucci, the graduate from Quorum, New York.
Absolutely nails that dismount. That's what you want to see in terms of the chest position on landing.
Big struggles for Vaglucci against Kent State on bars last time out, but gets it started early. And the Chippewa is off to a good start to rotation free. We'll go now to Taylor Reck, the sophomore, who's been a staple in the leadoff on floor.
Yeah, and she's got such a fun routine to watch. Great performer, really confident. So just watching for her to control her power, particularly on that double back.
Let's split it. Now we have bars with Sarah Cooper.
And actually beam with Cooper, but getting William & Mary off here, as I mentioned, just really thrives in this leadoff spot. Nice control on that front double full for Reck. And confident out of that back handspring layout step out for Cooper. And maybe she can hear me through the headset, because that's the best double back I've seen her do. A little bit of hesitation in that full turn for Cooper, but hangs on to it. Step back, but that's why she's in that leadoff position. One and a half to front layout. Really nice. And that's the best I've seen her on floor this season. Has struggled with the control on that double back, but I think that was the most controlled lunge I saw out of that. So we'll see if the judges agree with me there, but solid start for Maryland.
After Reck, it'll be Samantha Gilbert, one of our four seniors being honored today, who are also in the floor lineup. Gilbert will be second. She'll be really coming into finding her spot here after not seeing too much lineup action. Gilbert into the spot on floor. You can see on the screen now it is Quinn Skrupa on bars.
And just in a little rare moment of calm in these quads as everybody's waiting on eval. Ashley Vaglucci, 9.75 to start them. and Melanie Faulkner for William and Mary on beam. Some leg separation in that pack salto on bars, but keeps it moving. Oh, just too far off on that back handspring layout step out. Such a cool dismount for Scoopra, though. Love to see it. Yeah, Scoopra just had that separation on that pack salto, but I love when I see different dismounts on bars.
On floor next, Samantha Gilbert. Here is the senior.
Nice control out of that double back. Good recovery from Faulkner, just was too far off on that series to save it. Control out of that front full. Nice routine for Samantha Gilbert on her senior night. Congratulations to her.
Back to bars. Jenna Herman. The freshman follows up Samantha Shannon's 9-8. Look around, it was a 9-8-2-5 for Maryland's Taylor Reck to start off floor. Sarah Cooper, the 9-6-5, so everyone's trying to get those levels off in a really important fourth rotation.
Absolutely, and remember that 9-8 is really the pace to get to the 196. Nice free hip there. Nice height on that Takachev. Would like to see a little more point toe point throughout that release. Nice speed into this dismount. Drills that full twisting double back. They're pumped about that
and
one.
She knew it too. You can see the minute that dismount hit.
And Caroline Blatchford here on beam for William and Mary. And just shows off the same lines that I love to see her on bars she has on beam. Doing this triple series. Really solid and confident in that landing.
Left side of your screen, it's Rhea LeBlanc coming off a season high 9-8-2-5 at the Big Five meet on floor.
A little short of split on that switch split straddle quarter for Blatchford, but controls the landing. And sticks that gainer full. A couple places here and there in their routine, but she's really lovely to watch on beam.
On bars, you see midway through the routine, Adriana Bustella.
Goodness gracious, that Takachev is so high. LeBlanc getting ready for her final pass here. Just a little extra slide in that Rudy, but pretty in the air for LeBlanc. And a step on that dismount for Bustello, but that Takachev is so high. And she gets the chain and the cutlery, the fork, the spoon, all of those accoutrements. She's getting them.
Deserved there for Bustello. As we'll take a look here at William and Mary. On beam, it's going to now be Madeline Frazier.
Yeah, and you know what I liked about Blatchford's work before her is that she had a couple of places where she was a little bit off, but she took her time, she was patient, and that's why she's such a leader for William and Mary in the all-around. Nice backhand spring layout, step out for Frazier there. Really squared her torso nicely over the beam to set herself up for success.
On floor, here comes where the heavy hitters start to add up for the Terps. Maddie Komorowski coming off a sensational floor routine at Big Fives.
Yeah, set her career high, just beautiful toe point throughout this routine. A nice front toss there. Oh, just off in that beat jump for Frazier. And Komorowski, I think just a hair under rotated on that Rudy, but just finesses the landing. Look at this leap. Switch ring, Ferrari, not very many folks doing that in NCAA. A nice dismount there for Frazier, freshman for William and Mary. I think she's got a lot of potential. Owen was under-rotated on that front layout, but not going to see that 9-9-plus score that we saw from her last week, but she really does, she manages to finesse the landing. She's really quick on her feet.
From Komorowski on floor to a break in the action. Again, another quick second with everyone on eval.
And Michelle No here for William and Mary next on beam. She's a really powerful athlete, and it's something that she really shows off on beam, and I love when gymnasts are aggressive and really go for those good dynamics on beam. Smooth through that full turn. Just off on that back handspring layout step out, but hangs on to it.
And on the floor, it's the team leader in floor average score this year. Alexa Rothenbucher has been on fire.
And just a hesitation in that aerial on beam, but again, a lot of fight through this routine, and Alexa gearing up for this whip, double back, huge. A nice dismount there. A lot of fight on that beam routine for William and Mary. Michelle No finishing up there. Oh, it's just a little off balance there in that double pike. But gosh, she is powerful. And, you know, she is capable of sticking that double pike cold. Think she was just a little bit off balance and had to take that step to the side. But the dynamics in her tumbling are second to none.
Mm. Rothenbucher will wait the score of that routine following up Komorowski's 9-8. Another really solid start to the floor lineup for Maryland as we see Costello getting ready on beam.
Yeah, and some nice scores in here for William and Mary. They do currently have a 9 in that 2 spot, so that's the score they're looking to replace here. Backhand spring layout step out. Just was off in the air in that layout step out. You could see her first foot just barely got on the beam. Does that difficult switch split combination, same combination we saw from Natalie Martin. And goes for one of those difficult turning leaps on beam. Unfortunate about that series fall, but she's got some excellent qualities on beam. Sticks the dismount. Good for her. Nice fight after that fall.
You hear the music in the gym, and it's Natalie Martin's floor routine. Here comes a freshman.
And this gigantic full twisting double back. Great control. One and a half front layout connects it to that stag jump, which she hasn't always done this season, so nice to see that. Double back, just slightly under there. But, you know, we've talked about Natalie Martin all season, just such a dynamic competitor. Yeah, not, you know, just didn't quite get the landing on vault that we're used to seeing from her, but I just love her composure on the mat. Just has huge dynamics, great tumbling. Future is bright for her, for sure.
Yeah, Martin, only a freshman. And a big spot, the anchor of the floor lineups. And again, with the Olympic order, we'll finish off Maryland's day. A successful day for the Terps. Christina will await the score from Martin, but even if Martin's score gets dropped, a minimum of 196.175 for the Terps, their first 196 score in the last three meets. A big one for Maryland, and it will impact the NQS.
Absolutely. And yeah, again, remember, it's all about improving on the NQS at this point. So that is, they are going to be able to drop a 195.8 that they are carrying currently. Getting a look at the totals that we've got here for you. The Whitman. I mean, how cool is this to have a vault named after yourself? Check this out. Front handspring onto the board, front handspring onto the table, then twists it off, just unsticks the landing, just needs to get her legs together in that front vault. And this is Rachel Katz here. Getting a look at her vault. And she's one of those athletes that can really –
Back to floor we go. We'll check out 1 second for senior night. It's Taylor Osterhout, who hits an exhibition. A big moment here for the senior, who's meant a really big deal to Brett Nelligan in this program.
Yeah. It's really great to see her in exhibition here, and had some minor injuries at the beginning of the season and fought through it. Brett Nelligan talked to us about how hard she'd worked to get back into routine shape. Nice, clean, double pike there.
So Taylor Osterhout, the hug and a big smile from the senior competing in her home gym for the final time. A good career, and really represented the resiliency that Brett Nelligan wants all of his gymnasts to have, regardless of the injuries. Obviously, you don't want to have the injuries that Osterhout did, but never change that attitude. Coach said she always came to practice with a smile on her face. It pays off here for the senior.
Yeah, really nice to see her thrive there in that senior routine.
So there's Osterhout and Nelligan. We'll head to vault now, where it's Rachel Catch with a 9.85.
And does this big, this is Sarah Zoyce here, and does this big Yurchenko half there. Absolutely phenomenal vault there.
So awards are coming up next for this quad meet, and we'll be back there. We're all set with our rotations here, but awards are to come on Big Ten Plus. And we're back here on Big Ten Plus with awards on the horizon. Four meet rotations through. Ryan Martin alongside Christina Chauvinet. Christina, we just saw that graphic right there. A successful final rotation. It starts with Bars and Lucy Alvarado-Reed.
And these lines that I talked about at the beginning of the broadcast, she showcases them across all four. Little bit of a hiccup on floor, but she's beautiful on bars. And Natalie Martin, just so dynamic, full twisting, double back there. Really clean, high tumbling from her. And on beam, William and Mary really had a nice day throughout. Really had good series. You know, they came back, they did have a couple of mistakes here and there throughout the rotation, but really had solid, were able to finesse those landings.
Yeah, we'll see all those gymnasts get recognized for a big meet, a good quad meet here. The PA is up next with the awards ceremony on Big Ten Plus.
with a score of 9.9. From George Washington, Sarah Zoy.
And there you have it. Maryland takes this one with a final score of 196-35. And this one, Ryan Martin, Christina Chauvinet closing this one out for Maryland's lone home quad meet of the season. Christina, thoughts on this one? Maryland able to pull off a big one and help their NQS.
Yeah, you know, they're getting into that 196, really critical. They can drop that 195.8. They're going to feel really good. Remaining of their meets are going to be away, so they're still in the mix very much so for regionals.
Maryland gets it done. They keep themselves in contention, as you mentioned, with this 196.3. That'll do it for our broadcast. A good time here at the Xfinity Center. We thank you for tuning in. We saw Central Michigan, William & Mary, Maryland, and Georgetown. For our producer, Matthew Weinsheimer, director, Nick Quintana, my partner, Christina Chauvinet, I'm Ryan Martin saying thanks for tuning in to this production of NCAA Gymnastics on Big Ten Plus.